Está bueno.
Yeah, it's been really challenging, and I get very choked up talking about it and thinking about it because I'm in clinic this morning upstairs and was just running down because we are having patients. That is a really challenging reality for me, not just as a physician or an abortion provider, but as a person and as a woman and as someone who could become pregnant in the state of Florida.
I feel like it's all bad. I feel like abortion possibilities or other mindsets or opinions into consideration. So the fact that they moved it down or like lowered it to 6 weeks is crazy to me.
I'm pretty disappointed. I think that having an abortion just makes it a lot worse. And I think that, honestly, I think that the future holds a lot of deaths. So that's it, yeah.
It's tough, and I think it's a tough situation to raise a kid in. My mom had me really young. She had me at 15. So I've seen what it's like to really struggle to like sacrifice your own meal because your kid has to eat. And it shouldn't have to be like that, you know what I mean? So that's kind of what I think about it.
There aren't enough states left with abortion access to absorb tens of thousands of patients. With this 6-week ban, there will be an abortion desert in the south of our country, further worsening the national public health crisis created by the fall of Roe. Patients are now forced to travel thousands of miles away from their support systems, their own providers that they trust, just because Florida's government doesn't trust them to make decisions with their families and their providers.
It was overturned. We were told by Whoopi Goldberg that it was going to be like the old days where we're stepping over dead women in the bathroom. Hillary Clinton tweeted out, "Women will die." No one's died because they haven't had access to an abortion. There are no dead women laying in our streets. The world can move on without abortion. And I think we've been programmed that this is an urgent need in our society, and it's not. I think for all women, it feels like there's no choice. I mean, no woman has an abortion because of freedom or because of choice. They have an abortion because they feel they have no freedom, because they feel they have no choice. And whether they take us up on our offer to give them another option at the last moment, offer free medical care, typically they're very appreciative of it because it is a difficult choice. And we do offer one last chance, to turn around. And many women do turn around. It doesn't matter what part of the country, what part of the world you're in. And so I think it's very important for that. And of course, we're grateful for our freedom of speech to be able to do that. Men are the problem right now. It's a man's world. Most abortion facilities are owned by men. Most abortion doctors are men. No one benefits from abortion except for bad, irresponsible men. They're the real winners in this. It's not the women. They have to lay on the table. They often have to pay for it by themselves. They're often alone. The men are nowhere to be found, in our experience, on the day of the abortion. Men have been the problem, I think. And I think there needs to be a turnaround of that and men stepping up. My body, my choice. You can't really go streaking in most parts of our country and tell the cops my body, my choice. We have to wear a seatbelt, for crying out loud. I can't go into the locker room of the Dallas Cowboys and start working out. And when the security guards come, say, "Hey, man, my body, my choice." We regulate our bodies, particularly when they are harmful to somebody else's. Nobody going in for an abortion would say that they have 10 toes. There's another body growing within them. And that's frankly the problem. The fact that there's another body is the problem. That's why people seek abortion. They don't want that body to keep growing because they don't want a baby for whatever reason. And so the other body, which we strip the rights from, is the problem. And so nobody's aborting themselves. Nobody's cutting off their own leg or dismembering their own limbs. So the my body, my choice is, it sounds good and it's fun to put on a sign, but it's just made up and false.
I think it means a lot more deaths, honestly, because 6 weeks is not really a lot of time. And then I feel like abortion, it's still going to happen, whether it happens legally or illegally. It'll happen, like, on the streets. It'll just be unsafe. So I think Florida should really think it through to keep women safe. Really, yeah. I am 5 weeks pregnant and I am not ready to be a mom just yet. And it was really all a big mistake. And this place has been great. They have, we were here early hours in the day to be safe from the world, from everyone else. They have escorters to escort us in from, like, campaigners and people who are against us. They make us feel safe.
We can help you. I can walk you right down the street to the pink house. You don't have to do this today.
We are the only clinic in like five counties, and we get patients from Okeechobee, Fort Myers, Melbourne, Palm Bay, Indy Atlantic, Cocoa, Orlando. People come to us from all over. We get calls every day needing our services. And some of the people we've had to turn away because as of May 1st, they can't get an abortion after 6 weeks. And a lot of girls don't even know they're pregnant until they're 6 weeks. You know, they think they're 4 weeks because they haven't seen their period yet. So... And then we do our ultrasound, and there are six already, and the patients have to be seen 2 different days. So that's going to encumber the patients, because our doctor's only here Saturdays and Mondays. I mean, I just don't understand all this. All these regulations they're trying to put on women. I mean, they're making us second-class citizens. And I'm old, I can't get pregnant anymore, but there are so many young girls out there, and a lot of people don't even know this is going on. We told patients over and over again yesterday, or potential patients yesterday, they had no idea. So then they scramble, well, can you get me in this weekend? Can you get me in this weekend? Can you get me in this weekend? So I accommodated as many people as we can, like, you can see we're a small clinic, small waiting area, and we're doing the best we can this weekend, but it's scary for the rest of the girls that can't get in.
Yeah, they,
That baby's yours, man.
You can be the mother God calls you to be, man.
the climate that we're in, and especially here in Florida, I feel that I wanted to do something. I support the associations financially, but I also wanted to do something. And coming here, helping the women, just being a friendly face for the women and escorting them, that seems to be good for them, and it also makes me feel better. I feel like I'm doing something to make them feel better. It's sad. It's bleak. I have a daughter who's 34, and it really saddens me that we have gone back in the government has instituted these crazy bans. Women have gained so many rights. We have gone so far in the past 50 years. Women are not going to go back. And I'm hoping that, you know, I work as a poll worker as well, and I work to register people. And I just hope that young women especially, it's going to be up to them to turn out and vote in November. We have, in Florida, we have an amendment, ballot initiative to, you know, make sure that abortion rights, reproductive rights are legal in this state.
I get almost a shit. Oh, I tell you. I have to wait for my son to open up.
We don't have this close proximity.
Most places don't. The vast majority across the parking lot.
Yeah. My hat came from Cracker Barrel. You believe that? Cracker Barrel. It looks a little salty today. It's been in the ocean a few times.
I'm here because abortion has hurt me, and I certainly don't want to see other women hurt by abortion. They walk in the door and they never come out the same. No matter how they try to go on with life as normal, they'll never be the same. So whether or not they've had all the risk and education when they walk in this door, I hope they have, but it's probably not the case. Many of them have not been told what might happen afterwards. So if they've had a surgical abortion, they might have never been told that they might never have children again. Second pregnancy probably will end up in miscarriage. Sexual dysfunction, broken relationships, anniversary reactions of illness that coincide with an abortion date. There's multiple things that can happen after an abortion.
Smarter than that.
A doctor would tell you that life begins at conception.
You're not a doctor, but you're a mom. You're not a...
He'll be your Lord, guard over you, if you'll receive Jesus into your heart.
I believe it will be. I mean, that's what everybody I talk to says, because we had to get all those signatures to get it on the ballot, and then we did that. A lot of people didn't think we were going to be able to do that, but we did that. And then if every woman who votes for yes on amendment, she can be Republican or Democrat, but she can still vote yes on Amendment 4, it should pass. It should pass. I have faith that it will pass. But we've got to vote. They've got to vote. They got to vote. Got it down pat. We know how to do it. This is the surgery room. Shannon's in here cleaning up from today.